Shaker DB, why is he in different rooms all the time? Let me think.
Well, I guess, what was I meant to say? Oh yes, so the reason I film in separate rooms to get your attention. So judging from your comments, I guess I did. Welcome to another episode of Responding to Your Comments. My goodness, the channel is booming. We're getting nearly 1.5 million views per month and your comments are booming. So what are we waiting for? Let's dive in. Bianca Basco, do you mix benzoyl peroxide with water or no? And what are the proportions? Bianca, thank you for your comment. This is from the how to get rid of acne video. In terms of mixing benzoyl peroxide with water, no, you don't mix it with water. You need to put it on dry skin. I'd always also say you should patch test first with any cream just to make sure you're okay with it and you're not going to have any side effects or reactions to it. Now, if the patch test is fine, then you need to wash your face maybe once or twice a day with a mild soap and just water. And then once it dries, you can apply the benzoyl peroxide to your face. One of the most common mistakes that people make is they just apply it to single spots, but you should apply it to the entire area where you're prone to getting spots. But please remember that benzoyl peroxide bleaches almost anything. So it bleaches your hair, it bleaches your pillowcase, it will bleach your clothes, it will bleach anything. So just please be very careful with that. And in terms of how to use it, I'll give you a quick guide. Now, generally speaking, how I recommend patients to use benzoyl peroxide, because it can be quite a harsh cream to use, is to first start off with the lower strength, so maybe like the 2.5%, and then apply it maybe once a night for a couple of hours and then wash it off. This is just so you can build a bit of tolerance, or if you can't be bothered washing it off, maybe on alternate nights for like a few weeks, just again so you can build that tolerance. And then gradually, you can build up the strength of the benzoyl peroxide, maybe you can go up to a 5% strength, and use it once a day or twice a day, or however is recommended by your healthcare professional. That's the most important thing. Always check with your healthcare professional that it's safe and suitable to use it, and they'll also be able to give you advice as well. But generally speaking, this is how you can build it up, and it might help you avoid the side effects that it can cause, which is the dry skin. Banana Figrazi, how tall will I be? Question mark. Right, this is a really long comment, so I'm not gonna read it all out for you, but it's from the How to Grow Taller video. So he said stuff like, me, 13 years, I'm 170 centimeters. Mum, 43 years, 175 centimeters. Dad, 44 years, 172. Mum's dad, mum's mum, dad's mum. He's got all the heights. Who I look like? Mum, 45%, dad, 3%. Mum's dad, 50%, mum, 1%. I mean, Banana Figrazi, I have no idea how you have come up to this conclusion that you are 3% like your dad, 45%. I mean, how do you actually quantify that? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to calculate your height for you right now. So you said you are 177 centimeters. Multiply that by 3. Divide it. Yeah, pi. Times that by 73. Okay. Banana Figrazi, the answer is, I don't know. And it's as simple as that. This is not something that we can put into an equation and calculate for you. This is something that is mostly genetics, and there's some lifestyle factors that you can do that can help improve your natural growth that you're gonna have. So I'm afraid I can't answer the question for you, but watch the video and I hope my tips help. Thank you for the comment. You've clearly gone through a lot of effort on putting this, and I'm afraid it did get my attention, but I can't really answer it. Liege Ronya, how do you manage your time between social media and real life? Thank you for your comment. This is from a previous Responding to Comments episode. In terms of how do I manage it? Well, to begin with, it was very difficult because it was just me and the team, and I was filming and editing and writing scripts whilst working as a pharmacist and a prescriber. So it was quite difficult. So I'd say the most important thing that I always did was scheduling and making time, really, because I always say to my friends and everyone that free time is something that it really is the enemy of progress, because you always have two types of people in the world, and I'm sure you've got friends like this as well, that you know, you want to hang out with them and be like, oh, let's go for a coffee, let's go for a walk in the park, I don't know. And they'll say, oh, no, I've got no free time, I've got no time, sorry, I'm busy. It's busy, that's what everyone says, I'm busy. So free time is the enemy of progress. And if you think of it like that and you put in the time to do things, you will progress, or you can always be busy. But saying all that, I think passion really comes into it, and I really do love what I do. I love making videos. I've always loved it from when I was a child, and I've always loved pharmacy and science. So mixing the two together is a real dream for me. And I'm not just saying that, this is a real passion of mine, and I really enjoy doing it. So it's not something that I've ever woken up and thought, oh, I hate doing this, or I don't want to do it. So that has really helped as well. Thankfully now,
I feel like we've got to a stage where I couldn't do it all on my own, and we've got a team now. We've got Joel that does most of the filming, and we've also got Nadia who does a lot of my photography. She does a lot of the editing. Well, pretty much 99% of the editing Nadia does now. And that was really helpful for me. We're a team, we're together, and we make it happen. Just some guy without a mustache. What if we can't sleep because the dream servers are full and we're just waiting for someone to disconnect? Just some guy without a mustache. This is an interesting concept. Maybe that is true. Maybe going into sleep is like the matrix and we're connecting into the matrix, but if the matrix is full, then we can't connect in. So we're waiting for someone to disconnect. I mean, that's a very interesting concept. I mean, it's wrong, but it's very interesting. Imagine if that was true. That would be pretty incredible. I mean, we would question life entirely. Ed Boss, does the peel skin grow back tanned? Ed Boss, thank you for your comment. This is from the How to Treat Sunburn video. In short, no. Your skin is gonna grow back the same color it always does because your pigments, the melanin, is what determines your skin color, really. But more importantly, I know I don't like to be the healthcare professional who's all doom and gloom, but it's really important, again, that I tell you this, that if you are getting sunburn at least once every 2 years, your risk of melanoma skin cancer is tripled. And that's really, really dangerous. So you need to make sure you're protecting your skin. You need to make sure you're telling your friends, your family, everyone to use sunscreen, to spend more time in the shade, just so that your risk isn't increased. And please remember that sunburn isn't just when your skin is peeling. Sunburn is also classified as when your skin is red, when it's hot to touch, when it's tender, when it's pink. All of this is classified as sunburn. So please protect yourself, protect your family, protect your loved ones. I also made a video not long ago about how to pick the best sunscreen, how to read the ingredients and know which one is the best one from any pharmacy anywhere. I will leave a link up here and in the description below, so feel free to watch it. And that's the end of this week's episode. If I missed your comment or I haven't got back to you, I'm really sorry. We get so many comments, so the best way is leave another comment and I'll try and get back to you on a future episode. Also, if you have any ideas for a kind of future series or cool videos that we can do on the channel, leave a comment too because I'd love to read them as well. Always remember that you're awesome and I'll see you next week.
Hey guys, thanks for watching this week's video. Make sure to click that like, follow or subscribe button now to stay up to date with new weekly videos.